let's begin. Okay, so quick start to Eagle. Okay, so just get around to it. So about Eagle, so this is actually quite old software. It's made by this German company called Cadsoft. So commonly used by makers. So if you browse through Adafruit, SparkFun or Arduino websites, right, you'll see that they release a lot of their open source schematics in the Eagle format. So because of that, they have extensive library support. The problem is Eagle is a proprietary software. So they have a free version, but it's for non-commercial use only. Maximum only 2 copper layers and a 10cm by 8cm board size. If you wish to go beyond this size, you have to pay. And it's not cheap. Yeah, so there's some pricing plans here, so you just take a look. Yeah, multi-platform, Windows, Mac and Linux. They save the file, their format is in XML file, ASCII file, so it's very good for version control. This compared to another industry level software called Altium, right? Altium save in a binary format, which is actually very bad for version control. Okay, so I actually did teach a class on Eagle before, but the entire class actually takes 6 hours. So I will definitely not go through everything, like say I cancel out some of the stuff, and for some of the parts, right, I will not go through in that much detail. Okay, so step number one, we shall do a dummy project here. So our dummy project is quite simple. We shall have a LED that can be switched on and off. It's powered from a coin cell. The parts I'll be using, red LED, resistor, switch, and a CR2032 battery. Okay, so now let's begin. So we just start Eagle here. So the first step, right, normally is to import your external libraries here in, but I will not talk about libraries here because not enough time. So just do this. We create our schematic. Okay. Then normally to be safe, right, I just save as first. Save a file first. Okay. Stop. Sorry? I think all software has a chance of crashing, so it's just to protect yourself. Yeah, good practice. Okay, so I'll just save my schematic first. Okay, so now we'll add our components in. So the add button is here. So the first time you press the add button, right, Eagle will take some time to load. Okay, so you can see, right, it's actually... Okay, this is a part of Eagle which I really do not like. It's very hard to add components. So these are all the libraries actually. So in each library, then you will find individual components. So for the battery, I'll go to the battery library here. Then I'll add CR2032H, which is the holder here. So I'll just put it somewhere here. Then the next thing I'll add is the switch. So the switch is... Just press the S key. Switch DIL here. SD401. Okay, this is the switch here. So I can actually just right click to change the orientation. I just put it here. Then the next one, I'll add the resistor. So I can just search the part. Resistor here. Resistor library. For this case, I'll use the US symbol. So RUS0207 here. So here is the symbol and here is the package size. Okay, so let me add it in. Then finally the LED. Okay, so now let's add the LED. That's my LED here. LED 5mm. Okay, this direction. Okay, so now we have all our components on the schematic. Let's wire them up. So the wire command is here, net. Okay, so let's zoom in. So I zoom in by scrolling in. So the part about Eagle that is not, in order to wire properly, right, you need to do this. Click here. Make sure the overlap is about one unit only. If you more than that, right, then Eagle will not register that as a connection. So I just come here. Then I just do the same for the rest. So now I need to wire from here to here. So what I do is just like this. Certain distance, click one time. I click to change the direction here and come back here. So we have our simple schematic here. Okay, so I have all here already. So at this point, right, we want to use a function called ERC. So ERC basically checks that your schematics make sense lah. They don't have any missing connection. So for example here, warning is usually not so important, like LED 1 has no value, right? So to rectify this, maybe I want to give a value to it. Maybe I'll call this red, so people know it's a red LED there. Then I run the ERC again, yeah, no more already. But let's say for some reason, right, if I, for example, I did not connect this part. Or for example like this, I did not connect properly. So I run the ERC again, they'll tell me, here, overlap. So you should go and rectify the problem. So verify, okay, so for some of them, I just ignore, no value, never mind. Actually, resistor, I should write the value. So I'll just call this 330. Okay, run ERC one more time. Okay, clear. Okay, so now we'll move on to the board layout. Great. Okay, so we have our board here. So, but before we do anything, right, we need to configure Eagle properly to our liking. So the first thing I normally do is that I'll adjust the grid size. So I'll turn on the grid. I'll set this to millimeters because millimeter is a unit that most of us are more familiar with. Okay, so notice the grid is now visible. Then the next one is we assign keyboard shortcuts. So here, options assign. So I've already assigned some shortcuts. So later I'll go through what is red stairs and DRC, but yeah, I just put that first. Then the next one is the vector font. So normally you should take both of these, because by default Eagle does not use vector font, but when you convert to a Gerber file later, which is the file that you send to your fabricator, they almost always will require a vector font. So just pick these two options. Okay, so now, still not yet, we need to load our design rules. So for those who are not familiar with design rules, it basically means the limitations of your PCB fabricator. Because the PC fabricator, they have a limit. For example, your wires, your traces cannot be too thin, or your components cannot be too close. So as an example, right, here is I will use Alacro as an example, as a fabricator. They have all their requirements here, like a minimum, how about thickness, tolerance, whatever lah. So it's impossible for anybody to remember everything. So what a fabricator usually do is that they will provide a design rule file here for you to download. So once you download this file, you load this into Eagle. So let's press my DRC here. Okay, then I'll load the file. So I've already downloaded the file beforehand. Here, for two layers. Okay. Then once I load it in, right, then when I engage the DRC, the Eagle basically checks whether your PCB actually fits the requirement of your manufacturer. They will help your manufacturer to check, right? I load it beforehand because later I will need to use this file again and again. So I load it first. Okay, so here. Okay, so we load the DRU. Okay, then the next thing is to adjust the board size. So this obviously is too big. So the normal way I'll adjust is I'll just, for example, 45 millimeters. I make a square. Okay, adjust this one here. So once we put in, then we can just copy the components in. Normally, at this point, you add the ground plane, but I don't have time to explain the ground plane, so I'll just put the components in. Okay, so how do you? So click the move command here. Then you see that every component actually has a plus sign here. So the plus sign is basically, if you want to operate on the component, you should go for the plus sign. So for example, I want to move this battery holder in. So I'll click this, and I'll just move it in here, for example here. Then I'll do the same for the rest. So to adjust orientation, I'll just right click. Okay, so I'm sure you noticed the yellow lines. So the yellow lines, they are called air wires. So air wires is basically guide points for you to tell you that you need to connect the components, from, for example, here to here. So to connect them, right, we use the route button here, route manually. Then I'll click here. So this is blue. So blue means the bottom layer. We are going to design a two-layer board. So here, I will switch to top first. Then I can adjust the trace thickness. So this seems like a bit too thin. So I just increase it, maybe 1 mm. Then you can see here, we should try to avoid right angle because of signal reflection. So I'll just do something like that. Just click here, put here. Then you can see, right, you can get different wiring types, curve, right angle, and angles. Okay, this is low. Then if you want to go to the bottom layer, because it's a through hole component, I can just click, middle click to go down, to use the bottom layer and connect. This will work also. Okay, so at this point, we execute the DRC. So we just do a check. But since this is a command that we use often, right, I've assigned the shortcut key just now. So, where's the option to assign? So just now I use F6 for DRC, so I can just F6. Yeah? No errors. So for example, if I really do have error, like I do a something like that, so obviously there will be error because the wires overlap. So if I do, see, that eagle will point out. Yeah, here, like there's a problem there. You go and rectify it. So, DRC. Check. No errors. Clear. Then another command actually you should use also is rest test. So rest test basically means to realign all the air wires and tell you how many wires you have not wired yet. So for example, I remove this. So I run the rest test command. See, one air wires. They tell you that you have not connected one of the wires. So let me wire it. Okay. So to be actually considered done, right, rest test must show nothing to do. And DRC must show no errors. Okay. Then the next thing is that you will add some silk screen. So to add a silk screen is here. So what I'll normally add, for example, I'll add a LED board. Then maybe I'll add a revision one and so on. Then okay. So I need to set it to T place. So you can see these are all the layers of the board. So this is the top copper layer, bottom copper layer, all the pads, wires, and so on. So the top silk screen is called T-Place. I just put it here. I can adjust the font size also. You can see. So let me be 1.778. I just click here. Then I have my silk screen there. Then another step I will do is I will miter the corners. Let's miter. MIT. Okay, this one. Because right, at these corners right, if you make a PCB right, it'd be quite sharp. It could be a bit dangerous to whoever's handling. So you can do this. Curve the corners. So normally what I do is I make sure the radius is about 2 millimeters. Yeah. So just do this for all the four sides. Okay. Okay. So the board is, I think, more or less done. So we just run the DRC again just to confirm. Okay, no errors. That means theoretically Allocro should be able to manufacture this board. Okay, what about the next one? We generate a Gerber file. So again, Gerber file is something that you send to your PC manufacturer. You don't send your Eagle file, you don't send your KiCad file, whatever. You send a Gerber file. So how do you generate a Gerber file? So for Allocro, right, they have provided something called a CAM file for Eagle. So all you do is just download it, load it into Eagle. So I just show it to you. CAM processor. Okay. File, open, job. That's my answer. Here. So I've already downloaded beforehand. Okay. So it's okay, so I just need to click process job. Did I save? Okay, let me close first. Okay. So nothing appears to happen, right? But actually something has happened already. So you should go to the directory where you stored your files. You can see that suddenly a lot of files come out. So all these are the Gerber files actually. So to send to your manufacturer, you don't zip up everything. So here, for example, Allocro tell you that they only want certain files. So basically you can look for the files with the same extension, GTL, GPL, GTS, and so on. Here. Then you zip up this file and you send to your manufacturer and they can make already. Okay, zip up relevant, yes, so that's all. Quite quick start. Any questions? Yes? Sorry? As in which company I sent to? Yeah, so I normally I send to Allocro. I used to use Seed Studio, but I found because I use sensors a lot and Seed Studio sensors are quite expensive. So I use Allocro's product. Their sensor is quite expensive. if sensors, yeah. Because I do a lot of surface mount work in my company. Minimum, okay. Okay, the first, right, before that, I'll look at how low can I go based on by Allegro, for example. So I need, I'll look, like, for example, minimum track, PCB track, okay, here. 6 mils. So it's, I'm not sure exactly how many millimeters, lah, but you just Google that, you can find the millimeters, so we just adjust here. So, yes. Yeah, but normally they tell you, like, you don't go and go for the minimum. See, minimum 6 mil, but recommended 8 mil. So, yeah, so, yeah, well, normally, as a rule of thumb, you go for the thickest track you can afford. Thicker is always better. That, but if your board is very cramped, right, then of course you can't afford the thick trace. So normally, what I wire first is the high-speed signals. For example, USB is considered high-speed signal. Then after that, I wire power. Then everything else. Power usually have to be very thick. If I'm transmitting in like few hundred milliamps or one amp, right, it needs a thick trace. Okay, any more questions? Okay, yeah, so that's all. Okay.
So next will be Pao Shen. And how many of you have used KiCad? A couple. I only opened it.